Hey, welcome back, boys and girls. And we are at Sunday school lesson of 4 days of creation. So in your packet, you're going to get a sheet like this. You're going to get a coloring sheet. And you're also going to get a bunch of different foam figures that go with each of the days. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to show you how to assemble the pocket holder for your supplies and their things that you're going to color. If you want to take this out first, we're going to cut along this bottom line right here. We're just going to cut that right off. And this is going to help us be able to fold it up and make our pocket. So I'm just going to cut right along there. You can have mom and dad help you, but I think you can handle it yourself. All right, so then all we're going to do is we're going to fold it right on that line. You're not going to be able to see that line, but we're going to go ahead and fold it on there. So I'm just going to lay it down. You can kind of see it through the paper if you're close. Close is good enough. So when you fold it up like that, it's going to be bent up, and that lets you see the numbers in front of it, which is great. The other thing I did, it helped. You have to kind of do this ahead of time. You might want to start in this first. Take some glue. It should be tacky. Glue sticks don't work, so I'm just telling you that right now. And you're just going to want to glue just a little bit on this line, and on this line, and on this line. Done, not a lot. And then you're going to stick it together. And just to hold it, I just put a couple pieces of tape on the end, like that. And I put the tape on the other one. And then I just do that. And then I went ahead and set a book on that. And I just set it down and I left it. If you did it at night, you could get up in the morning and do it again. Or you can do it in the beginning of the day and come back. Give it a couple hours, though. Let it set. All right. So we're going to leave that there. On the sheet, while your glue is drying, you can color in all these. We're not going to use them all this week, but we are going to use them in the next two lessons. So we're going to do days 1 through 4 of creation. So go ahead and color them all. And I actually did color mine ahead of time. And the ones I'm not using, I went ahead and put in this bag. So just, you can color them. Obviously, creativity is yours. And you can use the ones that we don't use today. And you'll see the ones we're going to use here just in a minute. So set those off to the side. Now, I went ahead and did one earlier. And this is my my pouch that I'm going to use. I just went ahead and drew lines. You can use a crayon or a pencil, or in this case, I used a marker. And you can go ahead and color the 1, 2, 3, 4 if you want. And it would be fun to do it in the order that they were. Like, for instance, day one, what did God create on the first day? Well, he separated the light from the darkness. So in your pouch, you have one that is a light. They just used a burst of light. And then we also gave you something that is for light and darkness. So these are two things we're going to go ahead and put on or in our pouch. And for this one, I'm going to go ahead, set that over there. I'll turn it around so you can see it a little better. I'm going to put the light and the darkness here. And like they said, when everything started out, well, there was nothing except God. God was there. So there was darkness, but he went ahead and separated light from darkness and gave us the two differences. And then when you have this done, you can go ahead and just kind of slide it right in your pocket. Okay, so that's day one. Day two, he went ahead and he said there was a water all over the earth. And they said that it went ahead and separated the water that was in the expanse from the waters that were on the earth. So we went ahead and we said that the clouds were the ones in the expanse. And then like the ocean was what was on the earth. So on the sticky one, you're going to get a cloud. And you can go ahead and stick that on the outside. And on your sheet of paper, there was a cloud. I just etched mine in yellow or blue, but you don't have to. And again, you need to slide those right in there. These are just to kind of help you see and visualize what was going on each day. Okay, day three, he then took the land and he separated the waters and made the land appear. And so these ones are kind of like our globe, and these are the land formations that came. And on that same day, it even said that he made the vegetation, the flowers, the trees, and things on it. And it's so neat how God does these things in an orderly fashion, and he makes it for a purpose. Because on day four, he kind of comes back to where he started on day one, and he wants to put something in that space. So he made this expanse, and he had lights. Well, now what were those lights? And on day four, it tells us it was the sun, the moon, and the stars. Whoops, he's upside down. So we're gonna go ahead, if you get any kind of these foam figures, you can put the foam ones on the outside because they're kind of too big to sit into your pouch. So just go ahead and stick those on the outside. And I like the moon. And your other page doesn't have a moon, so this works out great. Except I'm gonna have to put him that way. Okay, and then these two come with your set. And so you can go ahead and put those in the pouch. And I think it's just neat because the lights, they say, even if you want to draw a planet on there, it said that he made the sun, the moon, and the planets. Sun, moon, stars, and planets. Anything that is in that outer expanse. And so this is what we're going to hang on to for this first week of the first 4 days of creation. You've got day one, separating light and darkness. Day two, he separated the waters above from the waters below. Day three, he drew the dry land together, and he then allowed, he had the plants and the bushes and the trees. And then on day four, these are the lights that go in that expanse. So he made the sun, the moon, and stars, and planets. Everything that you look up above and see, and the air we breathe, that's what is in this expanse. So hang on to this. We might use this as a review later, but for the most part, this is your craft for this lesson, and I hope you have fun doing it. Thanks.